Hello YouTube, in this tutorial we will talk about how to group things together. For example, you want to have a list of programming languages like PHP, Java, Perl and so on. So how to say this in JavaScript? And what is the term here? Well, the term is array, arrays, bunch of stuff on one place, right? So let's go. Var, we need to say that when we are defining that group, that array, and the name will be like programming languages, plang, something like that. And after that we must state that we are going to create new array. So new array, and in normal brackets we are going to state one after another elements of that array, elements of those groups. For example, PHP and Python, my favorite language, and C++ and C, and that will be pretty much enough for these testing purposes. So it is important to note, you must have name like a common box where these things reside, and you will use new keyword, and then what we are creating box with stuff, so the term is array, and then in double quotes we are going to state those individual elements and we will separate them with comma, right? So how to print all these things at once? Well, we can say document write what was the name of target, name of group, plang. Okay, and that's pretty much enough to extract all of them, and see, they are separated with a comma in actual result. Right, so question is, well, how to extract these individual things, because this is like a small kind of database. Well, we need to use box brackets. What is the name here in English for them? Angle brackets, box brackets, I don't know, who cares. So here you must state the position of that thing, for example, 0. So position 0 refers to PHP in this case, and some people will say, well, why is that not 1? Well, in programming languages, in most of them, we are counting from 0. So this will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on and so on. So how to think about that? Well, just think about this thing here, about first element as beginning of coordinate system, imaginary coordinate system. So it's like we have cross here, okay? But we are always looking at the right side. So this thing here, this cross is... this center is position 0 or index 0. So on position 0 we have PHP and so on and so on. So for example, if you want to print C++ by position, by index, you will say plang and what was it? 0, 1, 2, position 2. Okay, so refresh. And there you go. But I don't have any kind of separator here, so you can do that also. Like plus, and in between just spaces, one space. And there you go. So of course you can use individual document writes for individual indexes, but that's pretty much approach here. Let's actually do that because some people can be confused with this. Right? And that also means that we need to have br here to get into next line, br, and copy paste this down there. So for example, you want to print something on a position 1, which is Python, so you will put 1 here, and you want to print something on position 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, that will be C language, and that's pretty much it, how you are going to access elements in this are imaginary small database, kind of. Okay, so this is nothing scary here, very simple stuff. Just remember, you must have a common name for this kind of group, then you will use new keyword, you will say what you are creating, the official term is array, bunch of stuff basically, inside of normal brackets you will with comma is separator, you will state those individual things inside of quotes, okay, double quotes. You can use single quotes too, but I don't know, I just use double quotes all the time. It depends what you're basically doing, but yeah, this will also work. save and refresh, and there you go. So very simple stuff. If you wanna just imagine that you have like 5,000 things here that you are grabbing from some kind of textual file. So if you know the indexes that you wanna grab, then you can extract those things right here with indexes. So you will just put those positions here. You can create functions that will grab random stuff, that will grab every third position, and so on and so on. But pretty much self-explanatory tutorial, right? There you go. Nothing fancy here, nothing important. You'll just use name of that group, name of that array, and then in these box kind of brackets, position of those elements. Very simple stuff to understand, as always. Thank you for watching, for support and subscription. See you next tutorial.